Hi, who is this?
Hey, it's Bristol and my mom.
Yeah. Hello, Bristol Palin.
Hello, boys. How are you?
Hi, Sarah Palin.
Hello, guys.
I got to tell you, man, what a performance.
Thank you. It was fun.
Oh, Bristol, man, the judges. You know what? I got to tell you, there's a love fest going on. You have turned these judges around. That's awesome. Well done.
Hey, she's got that journey story, doesn't she, that a lot of Americans can relate to,
yep.
You know, taking on some challenges and overcoming. Pretty cool.
No, it's incredibly cool. And you know, what's funny is I go back to this when this all started, way back when, and we talked to you, Sarah, and we talked to Bristol, and I remember it was kind of the, look, I don't give a damn what people say. I'm going to have fun.
Absolutely.
Exactly.
And isn't that what life's about, really?
It absolutely is. Bristol's the one who's, you know, teaching me this life lesson, too, when she told me when Dancing with the Stars called her and she said, Mom, I'm going to get criticized anyway. I might as well go dance.
Right.
Yes.
Right. And you know, you look at the other, I guess, the other three that are in it. I mean, Jennifer Grey, I mean, good Lord, she was in a movie called Dirty Dancing.
Yes.
You know?
And her dad's that Broadway producer.
Yeah.
She's up in this business.
I tell you, man, I am incredibly proud, and I know, you know, Sarah's obviously incredibly proud as well. Mm-hmm. And now Bristol, you know, you got great scores. You got a 9, a 9, and an 8. That's fantastic.
Well, the first round,
mm-hmm.
she got all 9s for the Paso Doble.
Oh, yes.
You know, that dance we didn't know.
Oh, yeah, the one that
saying.
I had no idea what the hell you were talking about. Sure.
Right. She got all 9s for that.
Yeah, I didn't even know how to pronounce it.
That's amazing. So, all right, so now tonight, obviously, we wait and see what happens. But
yeah. But
I tell you what, Bristol, I don't want to be the kiss of death here, but you have yet to fall into that category where it looks like, you know, you're going to be leaving. It's the people watching, and it's the most watched show. I mean, 20 plus million people are watching it, and they're all seeing the same thing that we're all seeing, and they're voting for you. They love you. Doesn't that make you feel spectacular?
Yeah, it does. I'm very blessed to have so many people out there that support me in this journey.
You know, I'm thinking, hey, Sarah.
Pardon me?
Sarah, when you make your big announcement on the Bob and Mark show,
uh-huh.
I'm thinking your running mate should probably be Bristol Palin. You know, she knows how to get millions and millions of votes.
Good point.
Speaking of spectacular, Sarah Palin's Alaska was just amazing.
Well, thank you. And as these weeks go by, more Americans are going to see what it is that Alaska has to offer, and not just with epic landscape. They're going to meet the people who make a living up there and who can carve these livelihoods out of the wilderness and on the water and have that pioneering spirit that the rest of Americans really need to embrace. I cannot wait for these episodes to unfold because as they go on, I mean, I have these covert, subtle ways of politicizing a little bit, you know, as we take these adventuresome trips throughout Alaska with the family. You're going to see us hunt caribou right on the outskirts of Anwar so I can show people this uninhabited barren land of Anwar that we should be drilling in. We're going to show people our management for abundance when it comes to our natural resources like fisheries as we're out there on the water in Bristol Bay. And there's a nice narrative through all the episodes just showing people how Alaska is coming into its own. We're going to be able to contribute more to the U.S. and secure the U.S. and jobs should be plentiful up there if only the feds would unlock our lands and let us develop.
We had the good fortune to go to Big River Lakes, and wasn't that a trip?
Oh, that's spectacular. Isn't that awesome?
Yeah.
And people think that, you know, some of that staged, it's what we run into.
Yeah. Talking about that, it's amazing. And I, you know, I roll my eyes at these people that still find these darts to throw. It's like, really? Are you that bored?
It's comical, God's sake.
Has it gotten to the point, Sarah, where it is just comical, where you just laugh anymore?
Well, yeah. And, you know, Todd had that soundbite in, I think it was that first episode, where he said life is about being productive and it's contributing and it should be positive and people should be
busy, and instead, a lot of people who I think you're suggesting, they are bored, so they engage in the pettiness to tear others down, and we want to showcase opportunities to be fulfilled and to be productive. And, certainly we're going to see those critics and the adversaries continue to be petty and ridiculous with their criticisms, but we're going to keep on keeping on just like you guys do.
Yeah, well, I think it's funny is if somebody like Keith Olbermann were to do Keith Olbermann's Alaska and do exactly the same things, he wouldn't do it because he's a sissy,
yeah.
but if he did the exact same things you're doing, these same critics would be going, oh, yeah. Oh,
he's so bold.
What an advocate we have for our great state of Alaska.
What a risk taker.
That's a good point. That's
yeah.
Right. They'd be noticing also some of those subtleties that they're responsible, they're good. I'm sure that they would be pointing out, see how they love the land, see how they don't want to waste resources, see how they want to manage all that they have for abundance to share with others. I'm sure that's what would be picked up if it weren't us as the hosts.
Yep, I hear you there. Now, listen, pretty exciting news. We've had John Ziegler on our program the last few days that finally, on pay-per-view, you can now get media malpractice, how Obama got elected. That's a big deal.
That is a big deal, and John Ziegler did a wonderful job against much adversarial backlash in the in the political yeah. arena out there from the machine and the GOP and, of course, from the Democrats, the left and the media, just trying to put this together to document the way things have gone the last couple of years with the media.
Yeah, and I don't care what side of the fence you're on. Watch this. It's not so much about whether or not you support Sarah or not. It's opening your eyes to how the media can completely regulate an election and how they just loved and gave Obama a complete hall pass during the whole election. Mm-hmm. It's really an eye-opener.
That documentary should be used at the college level
yes. In
every political science course that there is. And in communications courses.
Communications, exactly, yeah. And that's my degree was communications, and having learned way back when in college the who, what, where, when, and why of journalism, things mm-hmm. have certainly evolved and dissolved into a sad state of affairs with mainstream media reporting. We know that Obama wasn't vetted through the campaign, and now, that some things are coming home to roost, if you will, with his inexperience and his associations, and that ultimately harms our republic when a candidate isn't vetted by the media, that cornerstone of our democracy. So you're right, it's not about me, and whether you like my politics or not, that you can push all that aside and just pay attention to what that message is in this documentary, and that is that things have got to change for the better in the state of journalism. Otherwise, it could be part of the demise of our democracy if that cornerstone erodes.
And by the way, congratulations. Refudiate the 2010 word of the year.
Ha-ha! How about that?
I explained that to Bristol last night, and she's like, congratulations, you invented a word.
Yes! That's awesome.
Fantastic. Well, hey, Bristol, I got to tell you, keep on keeping on. We're totally confident that you're going to be moving on, and we wish you nothing but the best of luck. And, Sarah, while we got you on the show, you might as well just announce it. You running for president?
Told you guys will hear it first, whatever the plan may be in whatever month that may be. So
yes. You'll
first know.
All right. All right. We're holding you to that. All right. Thank you so much. It's always a pleasure, Bristol and Sarah. Good luck. We'll be watching tonight, okay?
Awesome.
Okay. Love you guys. Thank you. God bless you. Bye.
Love you. Bye.
Bye.
Good. That's so cool.
That's awesome.
That is awesome.
Sports and weather next.